As we kick off our celebration of Black History Month, we want to place a spotlight today on education. Math and science can be two of the toughest subjects for any student, but there is a program in Chicago that's helping change all that. Alex Perez has more on Project Sincere.
On your marks, get set, go.
It's a short race. The vehicles are made of wood and old CDs and worth little. But the grand prize is invaluable, education.
It was cool because, like, when we learned the velocity, we got to add it all up.
Seventh grader Jermaine Smith is part of a group of middle school students at Dumas Academy on the south side participating in Project Sincere.
You just sit in the classroom and write and write and write. It's kind of cool because we actually get to do hands-on work.
5.59.
Mechanical engineer Jason Coleman is one of the founders of Project Sincere, which stands for Supporting Youth's Needs with Core Engineering Research Experiments. The program teaches students the key math and science skills engineers use every day.
Most students think that an engineer is a train conductor or somebody that fixes cars. But after being a part of our program, they understand that engineers are people that create the technology that they use on an everyday basis.
Project Sincere started just 2 years ago, but in that short amount of time, it's already spread to 15 schools, helping some 800 students learn more about math and science.
We're really taking it upon ourselves to really try to push the students and let them know that they can be great, they can be somebody.
That extra push has ignited a twinkle in Starshawn Harris's eyes. The seventh grader says the class helped her decide she wants to be a mechanical engineer.
They say it's going to take a lot of schooling and focus and concentration and patience, but I think I can do it. It does make me feel like I can tackle another thing because it lets me know that I can do more than what I usually do.
And it's that sense of determination Project Sincere hopes it can instill in each of its students. Celebrating Black History Month, Alex Perez, NBC 5 News.
And joining me now is Jason Coleman, who you saw in the piece, and Shane Phillips, co-founders of Project Sincere. They're both professional engineers as well. Let me first ask you, what drew each of you to engineering in the first place?
Well, growing up, I always had a love for figuring out how things work, taking them apart, and actually participating in programs at the Museum of Science and Industry that really helped spark my interest in the engineering fields.
Oh, okay.
And similar to Jason, I also love math and science. And my father actually was an engineer himself, so just being exposed to that field in an early age really helped me.
So what made you guys want to give back like this? Because you guys are no longer working engineers, you're actually teachers. What made you decide to make this switch?
So I know even for when I was in college, the amount of minority engineers in the field were very low. And when I graduated from college and went on to work in the professional environment, the numbers were still low. So for myself and also I feel for Jason, we thought that in order to fix the problem or to help to increase the number of minorities that we had to reach it early on in a child's career.
What about you? Was that part of your motivation?
It was part of my motivation as well. And I just know that with a lot of inner city students, they don't have the much exposure to what engineering is all about. So we really felt that it was our position to really reach back into the community and work with the kids at a young age to really motivate them and expose them to what engineering is all about.
Why do you think it's so hard? Because this is not just African-American kids of many, all races and genders have trouble with science, math and science. Why do you think it is that it's something that falls through the cracks, Jason, with so many students?
Well, I think it may be sometimes the approach that the teachers are giving them. A lot of times it's very dry and mundane, and so the students don't feel or understand why math and science is important. But through our project, we really show students what math and science, how you can apply it to real-world applications, and we make the learning fun for the students.
And so give me a specific about how, Shane, that you guys approach teaching these kids. Do you set up a curriculum? Are they always about experiments, or how do you go about doing
it? So for instance, the rocket experiment that we do, students are learning about trigonometry, but in order to learn about the trigonometry to see how high the rocket goes, they must make measurements from where the rocket's launched. And then as the students are working through the projects using the curriculum, they're getting background information about rocketry, the kind of engineering involved. And then as they get to the culminating event of launching the rocket, they're able to calculate the height that the rocket flew.
That's very good. So, but what you're dealing with kids that are middle school ages, typically?
Well, third through 12th grade.
Oh, that's great.
Yeah.
That's great. So you do start young. Because I was going to say, a lot of them, if they don't have the foundation, how do you try to bring them along in that area?
So usually we'll go over, we'll benchmark our students in the very beginning to see exactly where they're at with their math or with their science. And once we benchmark them, we can kind of help them fine-tune their skills. And we let them know what's important or what skills they need to know in order to do and complete the project successfully.
Okay. What kind of improvements, Jason, do you see in some of the students?
I've seen dramatic improvements, not only from their test scores, but also their enthusiasm about school. They love coming to school now. They love participating in our class. And now math and science is something fun for them because, you know, we make it hands-on. So they really enjoy participating in the program. And you can see it in their grades and also their standardized test scores.
Now, this is a business for you guys, a nonprofit business that you have gotten 15, 14 different schools here in Chicago Public Schools. What would you say to school systems? Obviously, this is an approach that seems to be working. Should schools just sort of rethink the way they teach math and science, do you think?
I definitely think that they should, and a lot of schools are. Actually, we work very closely with CPS and integrating our programs into the class. Like you saw at the one school we're at, we have in-school programs where we actually integrate our engineering curriculum into the everyday classes for
all
students.
All classes.
Yeah. Well, we do some project-based learning with other classes as well, but we primarily focus on the math and science where the students will come to our class instead of going to their typical science class, and they will. We integrate the science lessons to the engineering project, so they still get the science and math lessons that they need, but it's through the integration of an engineering project.
Well, congratulations, you guys. I mean,
thank
obviously
you.
This is a fantastic service, and you're helping to grow, you know, our future. We really appreciate that.
Thank you.
Thank you. And when we come back, all this snow, is it giving you cabin fever? Well, we have some ideas on how you can have some fun in 2 feet of snow.